In this movie, I'm going to show you how to insert images into an HTML page using Dreamweaver, and then how to make those images act as links. Both of these are very simple things to do, so let's get started.
Okay!
Before we get to putting pictures in here, though, let me talk a little bit about the structure that we're working within. I've created a very simple page here with two boxes. Each box we will put a picture into. If you look at the CSS rules over here, you'll see that in the body, I'm giving a margin to the top of 100 pixels, so that's what's pushing this down from the top. And the background color is black, as you can see. Now, the two boxes I've created, one called pick 1 and the other called pick 2, are almost identical. Pick 1 has a width of 600, a height of 200, and then this margin of 0 and auto is basically what's making the box be centered in the space. Pick 2, exactly the same. I just have an extra 50 pixels at the top here to kind of push it down from the other box. Looking down at the HTML code, you'll see that here is the body element, and then inside of that are the two divs, the div for pick 1 and the div for pick 2. Each of them have an ID that relates back up to the rules, which is how the style is being created. So now let's go ahead and get the pictures in.
Yes, dear.
What you want to really make sure is that when you insert the picture, you insert it in the correct place. So in Design View, some of the time, if you just go and click in the box that you would like the picture to go into, it will actually give you an insertion point that will be in the correct position. And so in this case, if I look down here at the pick 1 div, you'll see that there's a little cursor right here between the opening div tag and the closing div tag. I like to call this a little robot butt. That's what you're looking for. So the little line in the middle and then the two angular robot cheeks. So if you see that, then you know you are good to insert your image. To insert is quite simple. You could type in the code yourself, as you know how to do now. Or, more simply, you can go to the Insert window, which is right up here next to the Files window. And this gives you many different things that you can insert. Right now, we're going to start with the simple or the common ones. And so I want to pull down here. Now, this fourth one down on my screen says Image. If for some reason yours doesn't, you can click on the little black arrow right next to it and choose from these three choices. And what we want is the top choice. Once you do that, it will bring up a window that will allow you to navigate to your image file. And I've already navigated to the correct folder here, so I'm going to choose this image and then simply click on Open. And there you go. We have an inserted image into our page, and it's inside of the box. Now, the second one we're going to put in, you'll notice that when I go in to click in this bottom box here, it actually is recognizing it. Now, that is something that often doesn't happen. In fact, just before I did this movie, I tried it, and it wouldn't click in it at all. And so that's why you really need to pay attention to the code. So say, for instance, when I clicked, I actually ended up with the cursor being right here. That will tell you that right now the picture is not going to go inside of the box. So what will happen? Well, it's not the end of the world. Let me just show you what will happen. This. You'll see that it kind of screws up your layout. Now, this is a very simple layout, so it screws it up in a pretty simple way. But if you had many different divs and pieces of content, and you accidentally inserted an image outside of the box it's supposed to be in, it will basically just push everything around, kind of shuffle it up. And so this picture has now gone between the two boxes, pushed this box down, and obviously this wasn't in a box telling it to be centered, so it pushed it off to the left-hand side of the page. So you may tend to freak out.
Like, oh my God.
Don't. Just go, oh, I guess I didn't insert that in the right place. I usually think the simplest thing to do is just to undo. So that's what I will do. I'm going to go Command Z, get rid of that, and then I will simply go into the code and click in the place where that cursor really should be. So between the open tag and the close tag, the little robot butt. And then I will insert the image one more time. All right. So that's it. That's all there is to inserting an image. Of course, I took the time to save the image from Photoshop, and it's the right size and the right format. So obviously, you still need to go through all those steps. If you're unclear on that, then watch the movie on saving for web images. But once you've got the image made in Photoshop, getting it in a Dreamweaver is actually a very simple task. Now, if you would like to make these images be links, it's very similar to how you do text links. And so the first thing I want to do is I'm going to make this top one be an absolute link, and I'll make the bottom one be a relative link. So to do the absolute link, I need to have a full web address to go to, and let me go ahead and call up a web page with the address I want. All right, so this is the page I want to link to. So I'm just going to drag over the address up here, do a Command-C copy, and then go back to Dreamweaver. And then I will click on the image that I want to be the link. So I would like the top image here to have the link to go to that Wikipedia web page. So I've marked it. And then I go down here to the Properties window, just like with the text link. And down here I find the link window. I click, and then Command-V paste, and I paste in the web address. And now we'd like to do a relative link. So I'm going to click on this bottom picture now. And if you remember, relative means the link is inside of your own website. To get there, all you need to do is type in the address yourself if you happen to know the file path, or you can click on the little folder next to the link window, and that will allow you to browse to the page you'd like it to link to. And so I'm going to link just to the index page. Click OK, and now we should be good to go. So let's save the file, and then I will preview in Firefox. All right, so the images showed up just fine. Now let's see if the links work. So you'll see if I roll over either one of these images, I get the little pointy finger. That's a good sign. If I click on the top one, that takes me to the Wikipedia page, which is exactly what I want. And then if I click on the lower image, it takes me to my homepage. So that's it. The next movie, I'm going to show you how to do image rollovers.